Now I am taking up chapter 8th of your course, which is profit, loss and discount. And before starting up the exercise 8A, I am writing some formula which you have to apply for solving this exercise. Now in the first exercise we will be dealing with profit and loss, and in the second exercise 8B we will be dealing with discount. When do you have profit? Suppose if you are selling something, when do you have profit? If SP is greater than CP, then we have profit. And what is the formula for profit then? Profit is equal to SP minus CP. So this is the first formula I have written for you. Now if CP is greater than SP, SP means selling price, CP means cost price. If CP is greater than SP, then we have loss. When the cost price of the article is more than the selling price, then we have a loss. Then what is the formula for loss? Loss is equal to CP minus SP. This is the second formula. Now how will you find this profit which you'll get will be in rupees. How to convert this profit which is in rupees in percentage? When you are asked to find the profit percentage will be profit upon CP into 100. And the same formula now you have for loss percentage also. Loss percentage is equal to loss upon CP into 100. If you are asked to convert the profit from rupees to percentage. Now there are two formulae for CP, because sometimes it may happen that if we sell something, we may have a profit, we may have a loss. So there will be two formulae for SP and two formulae for CP. SP, if there is a profit percentage given to you, if profit percentage is given to you, then the formula for SP will be, and the other name for profit is also gain percent. 100 plus profit percent upon 100, this to be put within brackets into CP. So this is the formula of SP when you have a profit percentage. And what is the formula of SP if you have a loss percentage? 100 minus loss percent upon 100 into CP. Now in the same way you have two formulae for CP. CP is equal to 100 upon 100 plus profit percent into SP. And the 8th formula for CP, I have written so many formulae. Now the 8th formula is CP is equal to 100 upon 100 minus loss percent into SP. So these are the 8 formulae which I have written for you. And now by seeing these formulae, you can do the exercise 8A. And when you are going to do any question of exercise, first you have to write the formula and then do the question. wherever formula is required, you have to write it there, because marks are kept for that also. Now I'm starting up with the first question of your exercise 8A. The first question says, a person purchased a car for rupees 700. A person purchased a chair for rupees 700. Spent rupees 170 on its repairs and rupees 30 on the cartage. If he sold the chair for rupees 1080, what is his gain percent? So in order to find the gain percent, first we are going to find the how much is the total CP, and then we are going to find profit. Now I am taking up exercise 8A. I am taking up the first question. Now all these formulae which I have written, they are also in your book. You can see from there also. Now we are going to find total CP. This is the first question I am doing. Total CP. Because after buying the chair, he has spent some money on the repairs also and some on the cartage. So total CP will be rupees, add up all the extra money he has spent. The extra money which he has spent after buying the chairs, we call it as overheads. 700 plus 170 plus 30. This comes out to be 170 plus 30 is 200. 200 plus 700 becomes 900. Is his CP. Now how much is his SP? Rupees 1080. Now you see SP is greater than CP. So find the profit. And first you will write the formula as I told you. Profit is SP minus CP. Then substitute their values. Now we are going to subtract 900 from 1080. 0, 8, 10 minus 9, 180. Profit is 180. Now profit percentage. Profit percentage is equal to first formula. Profit upon CP into 100. Profit is how much? 180. CP is how much? Rupees 900 into 100. 10 cancels, the other 0 also cancels. 9 1s are 9, 9 2s are 18, and 10. You get the profit percentage as 20%. So how much is the profit percent? 20%. Now I am taking up the fourth question of your book. Fourth question says, if the selling price of 20 articles is equal to the cost price of 15 articles, then what is the loss percent? What is the loss percent? Now, no cost for the articles is given. In that case, we have to suppose the cost of the articles on our own. So I will write, let CP of one article is equal to rupee 1. If you take cost for 1 as 1, and there as there are given 20 articles, 15 articles, it makes our calculations easier. It is not that we always have to take 100. Let CP of article is equal to rupee 1. Then how much will be the CP of 15 articles? Obviously it will be 15. Rupees 15. Now it is given in the question that SP of 20 articles. 20 articles is equal to CP of 15 articles. It is given in the question. So it means I have written above that the CP of 15 articles is rupees 15. So it means SP of 20 articles is equal to rupees 15. So how much will be SP of 1 article by the unitary method? You are going to divide 15 by 20. 15 by 20. 5 threes are 15. 5 fours are 20. It comes out to be 3 upon 4. And when you convert 3 upon 4 into decimal, you get it as rupee 0.75. So CP of one article is rupee 1, and SP of one article I have calculated as rupees 0.75. You see that CP is greater than SP. So when CP is greater than SP, we have a loss. So write the formula of loss. Loss is equal to CP minus SP. 1 minus rupee 0.75. 1 means 1.00. Minus 0.75, when you subtract it, you are getting rupees 0.25. This is the loss on one article. Now the question asks you to find the loss percentage. Loss percentage is equal to loss upon CP, first the formula, into 100. This is equal to 0.25 upon CP, which is how much? Of one article, 1 rupee, into 100. And when you multiply 0.5 into 100, decimal will be shifted to the right by two places, and you can cancel it, and it comes out to be 25%. This is the fourth question I have done for you. Now I am going to take up the seventh question. Now seventh question says, by selling a basket of mangoes for rupees 105, a fruit seller loses 30%. For how much he should sell it in order to gain 40%? At present he is having a loss. But if he wants to get a gain of 40%, what should be the selling price? So, first we are going to find the cost price of the mangoes. Now, cost price of the mango, we are going to put the formula. Cost price is equal to, what is the formula of cost price with loss? 100 upon 100 minus loss percent within brackets into SP. Now substitute the values given in the question. 100 upon 100 minus how much is the loss percent? Loss percent is given to you as 30%. within brackets into, and how much is the selling price? It is 105. So it becomes 100 upon 100 minus 30 is how much? 70 into 105. And now we will do the calculations. Zero, one zero cancels with this. Seven ones are seven. Seven ones are seven. Three left. Seven fives are 35. And it comes out to be ₹150. So it means the cost price of mangoes you should write statement cost price of mangoes comes out to be 150. Now we have to find the selling price if he wants a gain of 40%. Now selling price of mangoes. Now first write the formula of selling price of mangoes with profit percent. 100 plus profit percent upon 100 into CP. He wants a gain of 40%. It comes out to be 100 plus 40 upon 100 into CP. And how much is CP? 150. This becomes 140. That's why I'm asking you to put it within brackets. Because if you have two terms, we call it as binomial. And binomial or more than two terms should be written brackets. So first you are going to add 140, it becomes upon 100 into 150. One zero cancels, other zero also cancels. Now we are going to multiply 14 with 15. 15 fours are 60, 15 ones are 15 and 6, 21. So how much is the selling price of the mangoes in order to gain a 40%? It should be 210. Now I am taking up the 10th question. I am doing 10th question for you now. And what does 10th question says? I'll read the question for you. 10th question says, a merchant bought two calculators which together cost him ₹4,800. It means this is the cost price of two calculators together. It is the cost price of two calculators together. Cost price of first calculator plus the cost price of second calculator. He sold one of them at a loss of 15% and the other at a gain of 19%. If the selling price of both the calculators are equal, SP of both the calculators is equal, find the cost price of the lower priced calculator. So, as I do not know what is the cost price of each, so first I will take let cost price of first calculator be rupees X. Then what will be the cost price of second calculator? It will be equal to the total cost, which is ₹4,800 minus the cost of the first article, first calculator. So it will be 4,800 minus X. Now we are going to first find the SP of first calculator. Formula again. Now I am not going to write the formula again and again for you. I have already told you in the previous questions how to write the formula. And it is for you, it is a must to write first the formula.
एसपी ऑफ फर्स्ट कैलकुलेटर, फर्स्ट कैलकुलेटर ही सोल्ड इट एट अ लॉस ऑफ 15%, सो इट विल बी 100 माइनस लॉस परसेंट विच इज़ 15 अपॉन 100 इनटू सीपी ऑफ फर्स्ट कैलकुलेटर विच आई हैव टेकन एज एक्स एंड 100 माइनस 15 इज 85 इनटू एक्स 85x अपॉन 100 आई एम नॉट reducing it to the lowest terms because as SP are given equal, when I'll do the calculations I'll tell you why I have not reduced it to the lowest terms. Now we are going to find the SP of second calculator. Second calculator he sold it at a profit of 19%, 100 plus 19 upon 100 into CP of the second calculator is 4800 minus X. So after adding it will become 119 upon 100 rupees into 4800 minus X. Again a binomial, put it within brackets. Now it is given that the SP of first calculator is equal to the SP of second calculator in the question. So I am going to make these two quantities equal. That is 85x upon 100 is equal to 119 upon 100 into 4800 minus x. Now if I take this 100 to the left hand side, it will go in the numerator, so it will cancel out with this 100. So that is why I did not reduce it to the lowest terms here, because 100 cancels out from both. Or in other words, you take this complete 119 upon 100, in the next line I am going to take, I am not cancelling it here. It will be 85x upon 100, transpose this fraction to the left. It will come out as 100 upon 119 is equal to 4800 minus x. 100 cancels out with 100. And now you can cancel this 85 also with 119. And I think 85. 85. And 17 sevens are, I think it is 119. 7 sevens are 49, 7 ones are 7 and 4, 119. So it cancels out with the table of 17. 17 fives are, 17 sevens are. And this comes out to be 5x upon 7. So 5x upon 7 becomes equal to, this is 5x upon 7. On the left hand side you get 5x upon 7. 5x upon 7. It is equal to 4800 minus x. Transpose this minus x to the left hand side. It will become 5x plus x. 5x upon 7 plus x is equal to 4800. Now take the LCM as 7. It will be 5x plus 7 into x, 7x. It will become 12x upon 7 is equal to 4800. X is equal to 4800. Transpose this fraction 12 upon 7, it will become 7 upon 12. 12 ones are 12, 12 fours are 48, if you know the table of 12, and with these two zeros, and 7 fours are 28. With two zero, it comes out to be 2800. So, CP of first calculator is equal to rupees 28
100, and CP of second calculator is equal to, because CP of first calculator was X, so it will be, and the value of X I have calculated as 2800, and CP of the second calculator is, CP of second calculator is 4800 minus X, so it will be rupees 4800 minus 2800, and when you subtract you get rupees 2000. And the question is asking you to find the cost price of the lower priced calculator. So out of these two prices, 2000 is less than 2800. Therefore, CP of lower priced calculator is equal to rupees 2000. So this is how I have solved you few questions of exercise 8A. Now today you are going to do the complete exercise, and then tomorrow I'll take up your problems of exercise 8A.